Hi guys and girls, welcome back to my channel. In today's episode of my modeling adventures, I present you my Marder 3M German tank destroyer from Tamiya in 1/35th scale and kit number 35255. This kit from Tamiya came out at the year 2002 with some new parts added. The overall kit is consisted from 6 plastic sprues, one small water slide decal sheet, a set of rubber band tracks, and one piece of photo etch which is used as an exhaust shield. So after building this kit, I have to say that I'm almost quite happy with it, and I say almost quite happy because everything was very good. The kit is building nicely, everything fits together like it should, the main gun has full movement and articulation, the fighting compartment is fully detailed, but the kit has a serious issue with the rubber band tracks. First of all, the instructions say that you can glue the tracks together using Tamiya cement. So I used extra thin cement and both of the tracks tore apart at the point I used the glue. So I was forced to use a thin cable wire to put them together. Second reason is that the tracks have no good detail and look totally fake. And I don't want to force them even more by gluing them so they have more sag. Now you probably ask yourself why I didn't buy a new set of tracks by Friul or something similar to solve these problems and made the kit look even better. So here is my answer to it. First, I had no idea that I would face such issue until with that kit until the moment I start building it. Second, after I realized the first problem, I didn't want to put the kit on the shelf until I find a set of tracks and then wait even more until the new tracks ship to my home. And third and last reason is that I didn't want to spend my money on this kit because I prefer to spend my money on buying new kits and not so much on aftermarket parts. So my conclusion about this kit is that it is good enough, but it could be even better if you buy an aftermarket set of tracks for it. I recommend it to every type of modeler, because it is easy enough to build, even if you are a beginner, and the result is pretty rewarding. That is everything that I have to say about this kit. As always, fellow modelers, don't forget to leave a like if this video was helpful or interesting enough. Also, comment if you liked, disliked, or have any other questions about this kit. I will be happy to hear your opinion about this build. If you wanna see more builds and help my channel grow, please subscribe and click the bell notification button so you don't miss any of my new adventures on model building. Lastly, if you want a brief history about the tank destroyer and the paints I have used, please check the description below. Once again, I wanna thank you for watching this video, and until the next time, keep painting and gluing your fingers. See you in the next episode.
sound of the 80s. Suddenly you hear it everywhere. It's all beat and all talk. It tells you a story and makes you want to dance. Steve Fox examines an overnight phenomenon, rapping to the beat.